What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Overhit video here on Fort Misery Gaming. And today, guys, we are going to be going over the next hero that we want to spotlight on the channel. So, I don't want more packs. Sorry, bro. which is going to be none other than the cat robot Necroid. So, in my opinion, if you don't have 2 to 3 dupes of Sophia, this girl or guy, I think it's a guy, is what people classify it as, but I think that this should be your prime target for your support heal, for being invested in as far as your resources between gear, between skill ups, between grade, you know, through those, trying to get as many of those rainbow catalysts as we can. So, like, if I compare right now, her to Sophia, we're around 1400 CP there and around 1100 CP there. So health wise, I think they're both at like 1400, if I'm not mistaken. So you can see there that Sophia will power creep, obviously, Necroid pretty bad once I get 1 to 3 dupes. So it all kind of depends. If you guys are going to go hard into farming Sophia's soul stones, then you may want to or if you pull the dupe of her early, then maybe you're not going to invest terribly into Necroid, because you just may find it hard to run like Cesaro, Necroid, Sophia, plus something else if you want like another utility here, like Proxy. So you could always cut Proxy and then keep Necroid, Cesario, and Sophia as your 3 support units, because typically now we're seeing that 2 DPS is generally fine for most content of the game. And even some people are even saying that if you just bring, like, for a campaign, if you just want to bring an Angelo friend, and then you could bring 4 supports just to try to keep everyone alive as much as you can and just let Angelo really wipe the board. So there you could bring, like, you know, Proxy and then 3 healers or 2 healers and then your tank Cesaro. So it all kind of depends on what you want to go for and what kind of comps you want to build. But nonetheless, I do want to take a look at her to show you guys the benefits. And the fact that she is an SR, she is incredibly easy to max out with dupes, which you'll obviously see her stat pool good. So you guys see here, I have 40 abilities and I almost have her skills completely maxed. I just need to level up her S2 a little bit more. But let's go into her skills first and show you guys kind of what she can do. So at level 6, she has a 60-second cooldown on her S1. It is going to heal 3 allies for 127% of attack, and then also cast a barrier on 3 allies that blocks up to 2155 plus 14.5% attack worth of damage at success rate of 100%. Duration of the shield lasts for 30 seconds. So pretty much it's probably going to last until they get hit, generally, if you're in mid to end game content. So the fact why this skill is so amazing is because it's a heal plus a barrier. So when you combine that with Cesaro, you basically have 2 heals plus defensive, you know, survivability abilities that is going to help you survive, whether it's in raids or whether it's in campaign. So I don't think she's great for PvP, because I think PvP, if you're going to bring straight healers, Cesaro is good because he gives a defense up with a heal, and the fact that he also has a reflect AoE attack. That's why I think he's really good for PvP. But as far as Necroid, I don't value her too terribly high in PvP. I feel like Sophia and Helen are just far better. Even at a Sophia +1 for PvP, I feel is a lot better than even Necroid or Necroid at +5. So. But definitely for campaign, unless you, like I said, have 2 to 3 dupes of Sophia, I think she's probably going to be an overall better unit than Sophia. You may want to, like I said, try to bring her, Sophia, and Cesaro to try to 3-star clear a lot of the higher-end hard campaign modes. But her S1 is definitely where it shines, so let's go look at her S3 or S2 as well. And then this is regular damage equal to 276% attack when it's maxed out, and remove one buff from 2 enemies. So it's a pretty cool utility kit skill, but the problem with her, since she is a supporter, I don't know how, like even the damage output there is only 276%, which is very low when you look at high end to like the final skill up. Because like if we look at for instance like my Dominique, that's also an SR, at her skills, even on her S Her weaker skill is 325% maxed out, and obviously this one's even higher because it's 316% plus 163% for dark enemies. So you see there, she obviously does not scale very well as far as trying to do damage. She's purely there as a support. And that's where also I would say that overall, Sophia is probably a better hero, definitely in the long term for progression, because having a full AoE heal plus revive is going to probably be more beneficial than having a three-person heal with barrier plus a buff strip. So I think overall, Necroid is still an awesome, awesome hero to throw on your team and to put in. But if you were to ask me, if you had dupes of Sophia at between plus 2 and plus 4 and Necroid, and you were making one choice whether to go, who to go in all in first, I would definitely pick Sophia just because you can use her in literally every mode of the game. I think Necroid, though, for raids right now, because we're really, really heavy in the dark meta. People are having, you know, Angelos, they're having Tez, they're having Cesario, they're having Proxy. It's just fluttered so much of more easily attainable units because most people have been rerolling for Tez. So a lot of people have a plus 1 to plus 3 Tez between, you know, SSR tickets and select tickets and getting the skill stone or the soul shards and stuff like that. So, in my opinion, I think Necroid's still a great fit on the team because she's also going to be very good in the dark hunts because she's not going to take extra damage like Sophia will. So that's where, Sophia's really hard to run in the high end of dark hunts past level 7 because she pretty much gets one-shotted on every attack. So that's where Necroid is going to give you a lot more stability because she's going to be able to take hits a lot easier, especially if you put her in the back row to try to keep her alive as long as possible to try to fully go into that clock. So that's kind of how her skills play out. So let's go into her abilities so you guys can see what different abilities she has. So this is her stats after you kind of maxed everything out. So magic attack at 4600, attack speed goes to 23. She's got no pierce rate, no crit rate because I don't have that for gear. Crit damage is 28, counter is 1.25. Then we have skill cooldown of 10.90%, so almost 11% cooldown. Accuracy, 100%. Status effect success of 16%, which probably I would want higher, like 30-ish percent for that debuff, or for the buff removal. And then we also have max HP. Her max HP is 1,400. Defense is 4,600. Status effect resist is only 12%. Block rate, 7.5. Healing received 111%, which is really good. And healing ability is also really good at 122%. So those are kind of her stats right there. And then if we go into her tree, you guys can kind of see all the different things she has. So her tree is actually very well put together, where it has most of her abilities are all beneficial to what her kit does. So it's not like, you know, she's got a lot of skill cooldown, she's got HP, she's got defense, she's got status, effect success rate, she's got status against status effect success rate, she's got status effect success rate, and then HP defense. So that's pretty much what you see across the board is HP defense, static success, healing ability, skill cooldown, all that kind of good stuff. So it's not like they're throwing in her skill tree, attack and crit damage and crit rate, things like that, of stuff that's just not really relevant to the hero. So that's why I think she's really, really solid for that. And then she has increased status effect resistance by 10%, which is pretty garbo. So you're never going to really use her as a lead, obviously. And then also, though, this is pretty awesome because if you can get her SR UR Grimoire, then you can basically get a buff when hit, cast barrier on 3 allies that blocks up to 269 plus 5.6% of attack worth of damage. So, and that's whenever she's hit. And it does have a cooldown of, okay, so the duration is 30 seconds, but there is no cooldown on this. So literally every time she's hit, as far as I know, I don't have a grimoire, so I can't test this yet for her, whatever the thing is. But basically, whenever she's hit at all, so like in hunts, it's insanely good. You're basically just constantly putting up barriers, putting up barriers, putting up barriers, putting up barriers. So I feel her value is going to go way, way up once you guys do get a grimoire, SR, UR for her eventually. because she's going to just have that awesome barrier passive of survival instinct that's just going to help your team survive, as the word intends, for throughout the rest of the raid. And then even in campaign, it's going to make your life a lot easier. So maybe down the road, I know a lot of us are just kind of going, trying to get through chapter 15. We can get our legend SSR and then get our dupe sphere just to try to progress our accounts as much as we can to, you know, do harder and harder content with hunts. But eventually we are going to want to 3-star clear all of hard campaign, at least on one, like one revive, just so we can get all the maximum gems we can. So, possibly when you guys get her SR, you are Grimoire, you may be able to go back into hard campaign, once you've built up some more of your heroes, and possibly be able to 3-star clear things a little easier with that passive barrier, whenever she's hit. So that is going to be my overall review. Like I said, I think Necroid is a absolute awesome choice to invest in, especially if you guys are just starting the game. Once you guys get 6 copies total of her, like I said, even if she's not your main focus, if you do happen to have some dupes of Sophia, she's still a great secondary focus hero. And like I said, you probably will lean on her more right now in hunts, because the majority of us are doing dark hunts, unless you got really, really lucky and you pulled like several copies of Ash, or you pulled several copies of other water units to where you're wanting to do the fire and water raids more. And even then, she's insanely good in the water raid because she's got type effectiveness on the water raid. So the only time you're not really going to use this hero is going to be in the Sanctum and the fire raid. Outside of that, I would say the majority of us are going to use her for the dark raids over Sophia, in my opinion. But that is my overall opinion of Necroid, guys. I hope you guys all enjoyed today's should you build this character video. If you guys did enjoy, don't forget to drop a like down below and hit that subscribe button if you guys are new. And don't forget to click the notification icon, so if you guys are looking to see more videos from me, you will get the first notification whenever a video goes up on our channel or when we stream live on YouTube and Twitch. So thank you guys so much, as always, for checking out the channel. This is Fort Misery Gaming, and I'll see you guys in the next Overhit video. Peace, guys.